You need to spend time, when you need a miracle, you need to spend time believing for your own. And you can trust with everybody else, but you need to trust and believe for your own miracle. That God can turn your situation around. That the very thing that everybody told you was hopeless.
Hallelujah.
Because the devil said, look, your situation is hopeless. And I told him, I said, you just wait. You just wait. You just wait. And everybody talk about, I got swag and I got this. The thing is that you better have Jesus. Because you can swag all you want to. When it comes time for the rubber to meet the road, you're going to need somebody to help you get through what it is that you're destined to get through to what it is that God has destined you to do. You're going to need some folk to pray for you and to pray you through and to believe God with you. When you say, Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. I believe you can do it. I believe you're repositioning me. I believe this is not where I'm going to be forever. I believe you're turning my situation around. I don't see it right now. But I thank you that you're turning it around. Because once it gets turned around, the thing that you'll discover is that every tear that you've cried, every heartache that you had, every time, every doubt, every fear, everything that you have been through, you've been through because God is taking you to where it is that you need to be. And the one important thing is that once you get there, you got to know how to praise him and bless him. The thing that God spoke to me is he said, praise me all the time like you're on the mountaintop. All the time like you're on the mountaintop. When there's not enough money, praise me like you have more than enough. When it seems like the bricks are falling on your head, praise me like nothing happened. When you're sick in your body, praise me like you're well. Whatever it is, he said, praise me like you're at the top of the mountain. Because see, then that way, folk won't know. Somebody told me, they said, I didn't know you were going through all that. Because sometimes your public persona ought not to manifest what's happening on the inside of you. I had to learn that one of the reasons that I was like, here I am in the midst of what has got to be some of the darkest days of my life, and people are pulling on me to minister to them. Why is it that you need me to minister to you? How come you're not ministering to me? And if you're so deep, how come you don't know I need ministry? But I've since learned that God, when God gifts you to minister to people, you don't get to pick and choose when you're going to minister. You've got to minister when you feel like it, and you got to do it when you don't. You've got to do what it is because your destiny calls you to be repositioned to a place where God can use you. Standing all over the building, won't you rest on your feet if you're able?